This is your CBS 46 News Update, brought to you by West Shore Home.
Good morning, I'm Rob Hughes. New numbers from the health department showing why the demand for a vaccine is so high. Our state adding 142 deaths from the coronavirus and 6,400 new cases. Right now, there are nearly 661,000 confirmed cases across the state. Vaccine registration reopening in Cobb and Douglas counties today. The county's health department posting this notice on its website notifying first responders, healthcare workers, and people 65 and older that appointments will be available after 5 this evening. We learned Kroger pharmacies will soon start offering vaccinations. They say their rollout will be a phased approach, focusing first on priority populations as defined by federal and state governments. While many are trying to sign up to get a vaccine, we're learning people are trying to find ways to cheat the system. DeKalb County public health officials say they show up with an appointment confirmation, but a quick records check shows they're not actually registered for a vaccination. Officials believe, despite warnings, people are forwarding this blue link from their registration confirmation email to family or friends to help them skip the line.
This is why people are sitting in cars for 2 and 3 hours. Then the person who was there at 9 who was supposed to be seen is now waiting because you jumped ahead of the line.
County officials tell us match registrations with appointment confirmations when you show up, and they will turn people away if it is fraudulent. Thousands of Fulton County school employees will roll up their sleeves this weekend. A one-of-a-kind vaccination event is happening inside Mercedes-Benz Stadium. We're told around 2,000 teachers and staff over the age of 65 will be eligible. Their spouses can also get the shot. Fulton County officials say they will notify anyone eligible for tomorrow's vaccination event. This morning, the Fulton County Board of Registration plans to certify election results from the state's Senate runoff election. Then at noon, DeKalb County of Elections will certify its results. A judge is ordering Atlanta rapper YFN Lucci to stay in jail after being accused of murder. Rayshon Bennett appeared in court virtually. Atlanta police say he was arrested in connection to a shooting on December 10th near the Westside Beltline Trail. One man died in that shooting. Bennett is one of three suspects who have been charged. All right, let's get the latest on today's weather with meteorologist Ella Dorsey. Ella?
It's going to be a great day today. We're starting off on a very mild note. It's cloudy, but temperatures are in the mid-40s. Today, sunshine returns quickly. We climbed to near 50 degrees, so it'll be a really nice afternoon. It will be breezy, but it won't be too cold. The cold air arrives tonight. You wake up tomorrow morning, feels like temperatures with the wind are in the 20s. Morning lows will be in the low 30s. Snow showers are likely for north central Georgia. The mountains could see 5, even 6 hours of snowfall. Most of us see cloudy skies tomorrow. It will be very windy. Temperatures will be in the 30s, only briefly reaching the 40s, with feels like temperatures below freezing through the day. Again, areas like Ellijay, Fannin County, up through Towns County could pick up 1 to even 2 inches of snowfall through the day tomorrow. It will stay pretty chilly through the end of the weekend. Highs on Sunday only reach the upper 40s, but by the middle part of next week, we're near 60 degrees.
This has been your personal news update from CBS 46 News, brought to you by West Shore Homes, Atlanta's one-day bath remodeler.